please let me give a round of applause for Robert.
Thank you, sir.
Come, let's clap for you for his life. Amen, amen. We just want to bless God today for opportunity that God has given us to celebrate the Father of the house. It's a great thing to celebrate lives. Praise God. We want to share something with us as well. And then I try to live practical Christianity. Hallelujah. Because I know as Christians, many of us that come from Africa, we like a lot of them. What's the word now? We like a lot of action. We like a lot of, you know, sometimes we don't see things like something common or somebody, or something rolled on somebody rolled on the floor, or somebody knocked his head, or pastor come and just jump 3 times and, you know, we don't think that God is working. It's one of the things we have as Africans, you know, and what God has placed us up on. We have God has placed people. But God, most of the time, don't work in that way. Hallelujah. That's why Elijah, at some point, was looking for a voice of God in some mighty thing, and mighty thing, you know, when he ran away from yesterday. But he didn't hear anything. Bible says that God now spoke to him in a very small, still voice. Wow. So God does things in a way we don't think. And that is why, as Christians, we should always really have a relationship with God. Hallelujah. So this morning, I'm going to take us through one or two things, very simple, and then use my life as well. Amen. And the Lord will bless us in the name of Jesus. Amen. And I want to bless God for Pastor Obion for asking me to come. He's a wonderful man of God, really awesome man. And because I've only been church this month once. You know, so one pastor will ask me, come. And when she made a call, I said, I'm going to come to have a few hours, but I ended up calling about the next day because I'm thinking, I told them the church that I'm going to be in church today. Amen. You know, but when she called and said, I have to be here, I said, well, you know, not some people, when they have told you, you can't do but to do what they ask you to do. You know, some people are very powerful than others. You know, so Madam is very powerful man in our hands. So I spoke to my wife, well, you have to go. I thought you were going to build me how to beat. And then you speak to her, I said, well, you have to go. So here I am today. And the Lord bless us in the name of Jesus. We want to bless God for having Pastor Isaac in our midst. The last time he came to us, the workers' meeting, at some point, we had a lot of programs to do, but I just left him to, so I canceled the program I had. I said, you just run the hallelujah, you know, because he took them on a very radical journey as well, because I always like that new radical Christianity, you know, because you can decide ourselves. I can stand here now, I know what to do. I can excite us and make us to jump up and do things, and by the time we finish, you may not even remember what happened today. And that is the honest to that happened just today. You just go home and then the thing eat you again and then nothing to do. You know, but today I'm going to give us practical things, what we need to do and how God has helped me a little bit. Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So it is a wonderful thing to celebrate Pastor Solomon. He's been a wonderful man since we met together. Hallelujah. Father, this morning we want to bless you. You want to give us praise because you are wonderful, you are glorious, you are excellent. There is no God like you. Thank you, Lord, for this day that we are celebrating lives, we are celebrating ourselves, we are celebrating you. Given us life. Thank you for opportunity to just share the word with your people and to be the means of your people to celebrate your Sabbath. Father, I say our thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. In just a few minutes, O Lord, let your word reach our hearts. Open our hearts to receive your word. Let your word have faith us and let it be purified in our lives. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. And people say,
Amen. Amen.
So we just take a little bit of scripture and then we pray alongside with the pastor. Hallelujah. I want to visit our vision, sir. And your voice is still looking young. Good. Hallelujah. And then your servant God. Now let's look at Psalm 90. But please don't mind at some point I will jump out because I will try and miss the meeting today. And because last Sunday morning we would have the service, they took control of the service. So I was there to see the practice yesterday. So you don't see me, at least just maybe the last 5 minutes I can turn up and say, okay, I'm here. Amen. Psalm 90. Psalm 90. We take from verse 10 to verse 12. The days of our years are 70 years and 10. And by reason of strength they be 80 years. Yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and will fly away. We know the power of thy anger, even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. Verse 12. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, one thing I want to encourage today is that as Christians, it is very, very, very good. It is very important for us to celebrate our birthdays. Am I high enough for that?
Amen.
I know some of us are quite conservatives in our way, birthday comes. Yeah, all right, you want to, because some people are bastardized maybe the way they celebrate, call and then, close the road, maybe where we're coming from, whatever, even here, ask them to wear SDI and all that. It's okay. But as Christians, you must celebrate the day that you are born. One of the things our children have taught us the last 2 days, I've said my wife and myself, is that they call it YOLO. You only live once. Because we saw them that in our own eyes, they were eating life. We are the ones providing the money. So we now talk to ourselves that I think we need to open our eyes here. So one of the things we must do as Christians, we must recognize the day we are born and give thanks to the Lord. You see, celebration is a spirit. Celebration calls for celebration. Now, one of the things Britain is learning from us that are of every minority is that this God must be served. Now they recognize that we have brought kind of fire back to this country. And this country can be too conservative. They don't want to make money, they want it to. They can close you off. It's a person. And that is not, you see, a shouting group is a winning group. So there is a shouting that is biblical. But when they brought out the word of the devil, it was too shouting. So we can't live our life like a Briton. We have to live our life like a born again, like a child of the kingdom. We're not saying we're going to break the rules, break the laws. But when they come to a place where we can make noise, we make noise. They make noise in the stadium. You can't stop somebody to make noise in the stadium. When Jesus is playing, talking about whatever, they make noise. Hallelujah. At that time, rituals they are not conservative. They make noise. Amen. So when we remember the days we are born, we give thanks to God. And give that to God the way you want to do it. Hallelujah. Don't let us be too conservative when it comes to things of God. As you're born into this thing, one of the things you have is freedom. You are free. You are free. That's see, when I became Christian, I was free. I came from a very, very poor family. Very, very poor family. I mean, so one of the things I saw when I was growing up, I saw a lot of intimidation, a lot of affliction over my people. People would just in Nigeria, people would just arrest you for having little money. You just want to arrest you for because somebody else. So I saw my brothers, my sisters being messed up. So I couldn't do anything. So when I became Christian, I have freedom. So I can do what I want to do in the name of Jesus. So when you are having your bad day, you must be able to give God thanks. You must be. It's a thing that God is happy. God is happy with thanksgiving. So it can't be too conservative about your Christianity. No. Maud is coming in May, by the grace of God, I'll be 49 in May. So next year is a big one. But every year in the past few years, I celebrate by what I call Palace of Praise. And I'm going to praise God. That's all. You don't have to take part of something, whatever. No, no. Come and celebrate Jesus with me. That's all. And that's all that we cannot eat, whatever to eat. But I need to let you know that God has helped me. Hallelujah. So when you have a bad day, it calls for celebration. That God has kept you for another year. Well, the Bible says that I shall not die but live to declare the works of God. So each time God saved you for another year, you have to declare the works of God. I ended up with my point. So you have to tell God, I am people that have said that. Because it's not the right to be alive. You don't do it's not the right. God can take anybody home. We have seen a 1 day born, gone. 5 hours more, gone. One week old, gone. So it's not the right to say I have to be here. No. God is the one that is the Alpha and Omega. The one that can make a life work and put to death. Is God that even put Moses to death. It was one that he took Moses to a grave. He said, you die. And he did the burial painting. So that's God. Amen. Man. So when we are Christian, we must recognize that God, I just thank you because I am alive today. So when you send the talent to heaven, wow. The heaven will say, I think we have reason to keep you from another year. Is that what I'm saying? So it is very important for us as Christians to recognize that. Don't be too conservative about your bad day. You may not have to grant the hall, that's okay, but get people, most of them able to praise God with you. And get your pastor to pray with you. Call him, that's what he's here. Pastor, today's my bad day, I need you to come and pray with me. That's it, that's what he's there. Many people don't do that. We are not getting involved with things that are not even godly. They are good, but they're not everything that is good that is godly. But anything that is godly is good. Amen. So why do we have to celebrate birthday? Because we have to give thanksgiving. And Psalm 92 verse 1 tells us something about thanksgiving. He said, it is a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. So when you give thanks to the Lord, it's very good. I didn't get my phone this morning. So when you give praise to God, I would say it is a good thing. It is a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. So many times people don't do good things. Psalm 92. It is a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. That's first thing. Number two, he said, For the Lord has made me glad through thy work. and I will triumph in the works of your hand.
Number two, that God has made you come through his work.
We are the handiwork of God. Hallelujah. God is still working in you and I. We are not the finished product yet. So when you celebrate your birthday, you are telling God, I am glad through your work in my life. I am glad that you are still working in my life. Can I hear you to that?
Amen.
You are still working. Say, I say, for that Lord has made me glad through the work. You have made me glad. And one of the things we must celebrate is that we are Christians. Many of us don't understand that being a Christian is a great privilege. Mm. And as many things we have that we don't celebrate. I am a mental health practitioner. I see my colleagues. The things that put them down, the things that make me, I just smile at work. Mm. Why, there's something in me that makes me different from them. Mm. I must tell you, I work in the community. I have guest load. Each time the break is due to me, once I've met them, they don't remain the same. That's something I know. So that's what makes me a Christian. See? So I am glad through thy work, the work you are doing in me. It's a different one. When we are Christian, when we are really genuine Christian, there's something that makes us different from other people. That's why when we have your body, you must celebrate God because we're a different being. I have testimonies at workplace. If I want to leave a place, they don't want me to leave there. It's not that I'm boasting, but I'm boasting in the Lord. So, Bible says, thou hast made me great and glad through your work. So, we must be glad. This is the day that Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. So, when you have your birthday, you must be joyful. No matter if your bank account is saying zero or minus one, it does not matter. It does not matter. Say, God can make that bank account to be overflowing. God can do it. But he needs you to thank him for where you are. That's why your birthday, it does not matter what you have not done. I have not done this. What about the work God has done? Give thanks for that. Hallelujah. Give thanks. And that is why one of the things I love is that, I love praising God. When we have our 20 years, when we're in the Brazil, people say, praise God. People are surprised. They were thinking, we're good. We are part of the state. We are just got people. We have rapport. We're not that age. It's good, but everything we do at Christmas must be evangelistic. People must have a blessing in it. Not just to dance and roll a bottom and under our load. No. God must be blessed in what we are doing. So we are past the age, we are not just even if we are not going to build a cake. Cake about from a small children now. Amen. We have a sap cake already in the boxes. But not to be caught, it's not use another half an hour to roll up and down. Go okay, the 7 step, 9 step, we use another half an hour. With that one, that's not to do with God. We need to send praises to God. That's what we want to hear, our praise. We want someone to say, Lord, I thank you. That's what he's looking for. So you know what I think we need to, I have changed so many things. That's why I say, I will use myself as an example. I have changed so many things in my life. It has to be to God, give the glory. It has to be to God, give the glory. My lifetime, I have changed so many things. I don't waste time for things that is not God rule the day of God. Hallelujah. Amen. And that is why the last point he says that we go back to that Psalm 19. Are you doing something this morning? In 19 verse 12. He said, so teach us to number our days, that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. Each time we give thanks to the Lord, our heart will apply to wisdom. Because we need wisdom to live in this world. It has become so wicked, it has become so unpleasant. You know, you hear some names, you just wonder, what is going on here? People are depressed. But when we celebrate God, you know about this, we apply our heart unto wisdom. Wife, husbands, things we think is impossible, when you begin to have wisdom, it becomes possible. Because in Psalm 136, verse 5, it says, you that made, it says, by wisdom, you made the heavens. For the mercy and glory forever. So, by wisdom, you can make our life. And that's why when you celebrate your birthday, what God wants us to apply your heart to wisdom. And what we talk about wisdom? Through wisdom, a house is built. Through wisdom, you know, you fashion your life. 1 Corinthians 1:24 say, God, Jesus, the power of God, and the wisdom of God. So, at the end of the day, wisdom is Jesus Christ personified. So when you have Jesus, when at the point you have your birthday, when you can reclaim your life again to Jesus, you begin to apply yourself, your life in a better way, because wisdom, you know, is the applied knowledge. Hallelujah. Bible says that Daniel is saved in every way because his heart was applied to wisdom at a very tender age. You see, wisdom is not for being a man when you're 90 years old. No. You can be 70 and not have wisdom. You know, that's why Bible says when you teach us to number and this, so that we can apply our heart to wisdom. So it depends on someone that wants to apply to his heart to wisdom, can you have wisdom? Proverbs 4:7. He said, wisdom is the clever thing. So therefore, get wisdom. See, with all your getting, get understanding. Because wisdom is the principal thing for everyone. You can say, child of 19, I have wisdom. And someone has told my heart, just, that's what people that have wisdom don't believe in that way. They don't believe in the greatest part. They don't. Because your life will be accountable to God at some point. Hallelujah. So when you apply your heart to wisdom, then you will live your life by wisdom of God. What is wisdom of God? Jesus Christ. He asks us to come unto him. So whosoever believes in him will not perish and have everlasting life. Jesus is the wisdom of God. What does wisdom mean? That we serve God when we are saved. Wisdom means that we give our life. We give. Because the Bible says that God loved the world so that he gave. Loving son. So wisdom depends that we make, we be give. Why am I here today? Giving. I'm here because I'm giving my life to the others. That's why I'm here today. So when we give our life to giving, we apply our heart to wisdom. You use every opportunity to give. You give love. You don't love by not giving. You don't talk about love, isn't it? You do love. And when you do love says that you give. Hallelujah. So that's why when we celebrate our birthday, we may just think twice. You sit down, count your blessings, and apply your heart to wisdom. Say, so that we apply our heart to wisdom. Why? You apply your heart to wisdom. Today we say many women just want to live life now. Because they're in a country that they say they are free. You just talk to a husband. I was in the barber shop on Monday. All the testimonial about the men there, about the women that said the negative. And they are Christians. Hallelujah. But I said to those men too, I said, you need to work on yourself. Hallelujah. So in Christian today, we just do anything. We don't apply our heart to wisdom. A lot of women now will make sure they will do things and the body will break and they don't know about that. I'm thinking, what have you been doing over these years? So why are you running about now? Some of them will not take and sell. You give it that they will refuse. And when they think that breaking, they now go back, phone, what prophet, a follower prophet, they will be looking for nine prophets everywhere. You know, I'm thinking, yeah, you do what you want to do. Hallelujah. So that's why when we have the bad days, is to apply our heart to wisdom every year. God, in the next year, what do you want me to be doing? As a mother, as a father, as a husband. Because every one of us must give an account to how we live our good way. Everyone. And to be honest with you, we can live heaven on earth here. I was to one of my pastors, then my friend, my close friend. I said to my mother, I said, God bless you. But the wife was doing this. The wife just called me and said, Pastor, I'm going to leave your friend. Ah. I said, swallow down first. See, nothing has changed. When we were talking to him, I was on to him in the way, I said, sir, now we are pooping fly with my wife. You see, Christianity is back. So we are going to go on the, after my birthday on the Monday, but we're going to soon to have a family meeting to call the man to another. And though your pastor has given you some provision and whatever, your home must not even must not start. Praise God. God wants us to make our heart a better story. We can meet this world nicely and very well. I said, there are so many things that have changed as a pastor because of my house. Because of my house. There's no point just going up and down, going to church part time, and nothing is happening in your life. Your life, our life should be a reflection of what the Bible is talking about. Hallelujah. That's why I'm going to want that when we have a day where we are remembering our day that we were born, then we must apply our heart to wisdom. God, what am I doing that is not right? What am I doing that is wrong? That is, what? Give me something else to do so that I can better my life. Many things have changed my life. Many things. People say, I go anywhere with my wife. Sometimes when my wife go have a party, someone in a place of work go, they have something. I go down. Why? Because I'm saving that in my life. People will look at that and say, because I'm a man. And I see women. Praise God. So all these, I tell people, when I had men fellowship with men gathering, I have this thing I do with men now. It's a vision that God is coming. I said, even your Facebook, your FaceTime, your WhatsApp, put your wife there. Put your wife there. Hallelujah. Wow. Let in my phone now, you look at my phone now, the screen one, it's my wife there. Where am I? Oh, my wife. So that whatever I'm seeing, when I look at it, I'm seeing her face. It's wisdom. Because I'm telling you, when we get close as man and woman, that time you get too close, man and woman get too close, you are not going to rub you off. Your speaking tongue will not talk again. You don't know your thoughts are like going down. But you know, that's not how. So, what we are saying is that we must apply our heart to wisdom. You must open your heart, open your eyes. You must do things that you need to do. Like us all. You must apply it to wisdom. How could a wife at home be talking to her husband now? That's not wisdom. That's not wisdom there. Look at your head. Your people, your other one is doing it. You're so negative to your husband, and the person you leave the baby, because whatever you say is what you get. God said, it's a true, so true as I live. He said, as you have spoken in my ear, so I will do. So we must speak positive all the time. Hallelujah. So it's very interesting that I just said, my wife. People see my wife going through something. I told them, I said, you don't know what I do to give my heart to do many things. I have three or four courses that in this country that I had to stop because of my home. It's wisdom. What have you? If it's not money, we'll get it. We'll do another course. But my home, we are together now. That is my first touch. Hallelujah. That's not why you went up and down, and you're going to call you at this and then you're going to going home and then
you tell me that. Young one, you don't allow your boy to kiss you. When you start kissing you, you're kissing you to things that you don't want to. We don't decrease that. You run away from things like that until the day of his wisdom. It's a practical stuff.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You don't need your mind to have a cost. You know, many a time people suffer because of what they see they've sown many years.
Figure that out.
So why sow seed now that you will regret later? Apply your heart to wisdom.
We are separated by Solomon because we want to apply our heart to wisdom. That's how it tells us.
And then change our lifestyle. Wisdom, it means that when we are in a place, we are building in this country, live in this country. Don't live in too many countries. That's wisdom.
And then, because of Africa, you are not here, you are not in Africa.
That's not wisdom.
Everywhere, when I mention that God gave me something about prosper the world, when I talk about this, people look at me and say, this man is foolish. I say, that he one of these.
I said, I live here. This is my home now. I was born in Nigeria, yes. There's nowhere in the Bible that says I must die in Nigeria. There's no place in that Bible that says, where you are born, where you are dying. There's no place. I'm a Christian. I'm a child of God. So the whole world belongs to my father. So I can give you what. That's why I take all this, my wife, myself, to countries. Because I have to step in every nature of the world. I was telling my son, I feel like going to Australia. The Australia, I said, yes. It's part of where my father lives. People go and put imaginary beds in park somewhere in Ghana or in Zimbabwe, go there 1 week, you know, and come back to England and run after buses. And I'm thinking, that's not wisdom. That's not wisdom. You being a place, you will stay in the place.
Hallelujah.
I am here, honey, I'm here, Papa.
Hallelujah.
It's wisdom. I don't have to rise. I don't have anything in Nigeria. I go to Nigeria now, I go to hotel, I'm in Nigeria. I will check myself to hotel and check out. Praise the Lord. So, you know, people try to build houses and they die in the process of it. So they have heart attack. Got somebody, you know, you do things that are foolish.
Hallelujah.
If you come to my house, they will tell you. I've been dreaming of a suit house. Like everything. My house now is 5 bedrooms, 6 bedrooms, but 5 bedrooms are in suit. We just made it last 2 years. Wisdom. So when people come from Nigeria or anywhere, they want to come to UK, they want to come to UK, they come to money. Not other people. I'm here, Papa. So when we are in a place, be there. I pray for this country. I pray this country well because this is where I live. I've been here for 19 years. Some people are still here, 25 years, they're still going back. And yes, you know, they are still living in a place. You know, just, you know, if you want to be in a Ghana, go there, go and stay there. You must have a center of where you go. I'm not saying you can't do anything like that, but have a base. Belong to Abraham was given birth in Hall of Chalice, but he had to end up in Ghana. Praise God. The Bible says we must apply our hearts to wisdom. Many people are doing many things that are not wise. That's why a lot of people are doing in the home, family. But you are sending money there, your wife is not happy, your wife is sending money, you're not happy. We don't send money to anybody in our house. Anyone that wants to build our house, we all talk about this and it goes out. And that's why we are peaceful in our home.
Hallelujah.
I've done my best to say, my desire. When my son is 20, is to hand him over a key of his flat.
If you take over the flat, that's your investment.
That's my desire.
Not to give me a car that will, when you bought a car, it crashed in 2 weeks. The car is there. You miss us. I don't care what the car is. After the degree, you got this degree, crash it. But we give him a flat. That's our desire. This is your car, and this is your house. Whatever is coming out from it, your accounts, that's it. You manage it.
That's my desire. That's wisdom. Praise God. because we do things that are not wise. We get cancer from people that don't even know what they're doing. I would say, teach us to number our days so that we can acquire our wisdom. God knows why. Because, and I said that each year, you need to take account of your life. Each year. 3 years ago, I was taking account of my life. I'm going to end with this. And I work in the church for 4 years that I've come to this country. And I realized that I work for what I get, is not what I get. What I work is not what I get. I said, I mean, I work, I know myself. Because being a Christian, as I said to you, anytime they stand clan to me, they can't even say. The toughest one, even the later one, there was a guy that the last 4 months they had not taken injection, that people were afraid that they're going to relapse. I said, no problem. So when I finally got to meet him after 3 months, we met twice. I said, we're going to have this injection. You know, and behold, the last time I met him on Friday, he had injection. For me, it's a great thing. Hallelujah. That guy will remember I'm sitting there. That is, it is 2-3 years ago, I was like, ah, God, I can't. This morning I'm getting, before one week is finished. You know, a lady came as an agency to our place of work. And I was talking about this limited company. And I used to was just starting up. And I've been praying, God give me something. When I captured, I mean, when I get anything that I'm asking for, I didn't even talk to that lady. Before that lady knew, every time 5 agencies. So when I told her, I said, no, I said, no, 5 agencies. The first one, I said to my manager, I said, I'm off, I resigned. She went to the toilet, but when I came back, I gave my signature. I said, what's happening? I said, I'm feeling with you, I can't do this again. And I come back, I'll resign. But if I did it before, I was doing it. So I resigned first before I call. So before I know, my first job as a limited company was someone in Harrow. I can't tell you what they offered me. When the lady had, when I told her what they offered me, I brought £3 down. She was screaming, she said, these people don't want to kill me, they can give me insurance. I said, I don't know about you. So even if I tell her that 2 months, maybe she's going to collapse. And from that moment, remember, September 2013, I have been working. And that's why I was able to do what I do in the house. Hallelujah. Why? Because when we apply our heart to wisdom, God will tell us what to do. And today, now I know that I have worked as a nurse. And that's really, the one I've done, I think I will just help him and my family to pay tax and all the one I'm doing now, that's top power. Every week when I went from the country, I feel good. Amen. Well, because I have planned my heart wisdom. Brothers and sisters, when we have been placed, let the day and offer. Let's seek counsel of God. Don't ever leave life in the house. The best way to live life is that we enjoy what God has done to us. Now, me and my wife have been flying to places. Our first holiday we have was in Dubai, the big one. We normally have one here. When I pay for the flight, I feel in my spirit. Praise God. And the Lord prospers the name of Jesus. May the wisdom of God rest upon you in the name of Jesus. Amen. From today, as we celebrate Pastor Adia, you too will celebrate your life in the name of Jesus. Amen. And you begin to apply your heart to wisdom. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Sister, there's no pain in fighting anybody. There's no pain in it. I was saying to myself, the best people that I have gained in fighting is boxers. Recently, I had to negotiate. I was told that he bought 8,000 car for his mother. That kind of fight, we should fight. But as Christians, we must not be involved with anything. You know, we should be. I propose to fight the good fight of faith. Fight the name, not somebody. That's wisdom. I don't get involved in things that I don't concern you. That's my life. I don't get it. Because when you bring something, I say, you get benefit, is
What we're talking about, will you give us something? Will you move it forward? No. I'm not involved in something that you talk, I talk, you shout, I shout, and when you feel we all have a problem, have a headache. You know, that's not wisdom. I want to talk, just want to make receipt from fighting anybody.
Amen. Amen.
Fight boxing, no wrestling, that will give you money. Hallelujah. Anything aside that, don't do it. Don't do it. It's wisdom. Hallelujah. And God has been a blessing to me and my household. Hallelujah. I cannot but to bless God. I just want to. That's why when you're a Christian, you are different. That was my new creation. All things are past. We are building. All things are becoming. Namely your spirit, namely your career, namely your marriage, namely your relationship. As the child who you are about to wisdom, you begin to savor your relationship. Which one is good for me? I don't have too many friends. I don't want. But the one I have, they are good ones. They are good ones. Amen. Because I want to live this world as a Christian, for a Christian that enjoys life. Hallelujah. My next car is Bentley. You saw this yesterday. My wife. We saw that Bentley to Nigeria and said, I said 6.0 liter. He said, wow. I said, I can't take that to work. I won't try. It's for Sundays, you know, some services. Like today, what should I bring here? It's possible. Some people try that. They saw the Nigerian driving and said, it's an Nigerian. Yeah, those are two. I just told them, I'm a Christian, my father wants. I do it to work to the glory of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm telling you, if all of us pass on cars here, we have more people here. It's when you do it not to now take one and then not go away, say, Pastor, I don't see. No, no. You take it to church and say, Pastor, that blessing your own is coming through, and this is your own something. And when we light up big cars here, we see people. I will give it before we pray. Our pastor, Pastor Francis, the altar of prayer, you know, is my pastor. So, when he was talking about this conservative something, you know, someone came to his flat, to his surgery, to GP, that, oh, all this pastor today, he goes GP and all that, blah, blah, blah. So, he was getting a bit in the data about that. And you know, we were now still in the meeting. And I said, I don't know about that. He said, you are a GP. Your salary is about 7,000. You can buy it from the bank. You are not, apart from being a pastor that you're serving, you are a GP. So, when I sent this to him, you know what happened? Because at that time, I already bought my history. 2 weeks after, he just moved to my house with that girl. I said, ah, this one is nice. You know, he said, one of the youth saw it. Because as a church, the way the pastor grows up, he can tell the church. So one of the youth now snapshot the car to his friend, the youth, all these girls, the young guy. The following Sunday, two of them came to church. I want to look at pastor's car. Two of them. Now, if they're not born again, and they meet Jesus, and they can be born again, and that can change. Just because pastor changed. Praise God. No, I'm not talking about you should not be going and be good for no, but I spent for everything. I was using Corsa for many years. 1.2 Corsa. As a tall man, people would say, what are you doing this one? I said, don't worry, my time is coming. It was time. When my time came, straight to Esprit, from Corsa to Esprit. Cash down, praise God. Because God has worked through me, I am glad. Hallelujah. The Lord walked through all of us in the name of Jesus. We make us glad in the name of Jesus. We shall be well with you and your household in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. God bless you for this morning. Come, let's give God a clap of hands. Pastor, I call him Pastor Saul.